So, can you go to the furthest one out, Wen, for a second?
Yeah. Okay, guys. I'm going to turn the mic off. We're going to have everything as it will be tonight.
Okay.
So, you can see here what's being pushed up on the screens. So, it's just a full zero.
Now onto the main event, which is introducing this year's startups. And I must say that I'm absolutely thrilled with the quality of the teams that we have going through this year's program. We had 56 applications and 6 made it the final cut. Starting us off tonight, we have...
You know, you're not a startup until you carry a couch. I can't believe nobody took it. It's just sitting outside.
Today, we actually brought a real sofa that we actually made.
Prototype.
Yeah.
So today is the final stage in the selection process. Obviously, we've had the online application and the videos. We've had the pitch night.
Thank you.
And we've culled it down to the top 21 startups for a selection interview of 15 minutes. Each startup is given a couple of minutes to pitch their idea and their business, and then we have 13 minutes of Q&A with the selection panel to really grill them and get down the nitty-gritty of their businesses to find out if they should be an entrepreneurial fellow for 2014. And at the end of the day, we're not leaving until we have 6 startups that are going through our program for 2014. We're fortunate this year to have had 4 of the brightest minds in the Melbourne startup ecosystem as part of our selection panel. We have Lenny Mayo, who is the inaugural chairman of Startup Victoria. He's a founding investor in 99 Designs and has co-founded businesses such as Learnable and Flipper. We also have Darcy Norton, who is a partner at Adventure Capital, which is a preeminent venture capitalist here in Melbourne. We have David Schuller, who's a co-founder and managing partner of Southern Innovation, which is a technology firm that was developed out of research at the University of Melbourne. And finally, we have Jeremy Crable. Jeremy is a co-founder of Dashcord, which is a marketing automation platform. And he also has a wealth of experience in the US, in Australia, in startups, in developing products and building teams. The startups are under a lot of pressure because there's a lot on the line. Those who are successful will get $20,000, office space, mentoring. They'll get to say that the University of Melbourne is supporting their startup, and that's a big brand name to have behind you. And on top of that, we'll travel to Sydney and Silicon Valley to meet with investors and other entrepreneurs who can help take their startups forward.
So we're confident that we've been able to sell. Our average order dollar value is $1,000 on our site. I think we got our points across. They ask good questions, which is always good. Like if they're asking good questions, it means they're engaged. I think Jeremy also gave some good sort of suggestions around IP, which we've been thinking about. And I think you know, owning that IP would be good. Yeah, so it's good. I think the biggest learning for us has really been about thinking about our business and going, what exactly is good about our business? What exactly is not good about our business? Because when you need to pitch to a committee or to an investment company, you need to be able to analyze your business. I think that has been beneficial in itself.
Working with people who have a dream or a vision to do something that is really hard and who are willing to take the road less traveled, that makes for an interesting life and interesting stories.
So how do you guys think Tuesday went?
It wasn't as optimal as we'd hoped.
Oh, we hit a slight hiccup and they keep asking, and I was like, look, we'll just see what happens, it is what it is, and just be patient. And
I think we could have explained a broader picture. I think we're focusing quite specifically on the UX.
weeks, which is our first place, so it makes sense that.
I think we're pretty exhausted, like, getting back. Like, I don't know if you guys know that, we got an Airtasker guy to bring, like, a cow chat. So we all crammed back inside this U, and we were, like, on Kingsway, and it was, like, traffic. I was just, like, by the time I got home, I was just exhausted.
So are you familiar with Melbourne University's tradition? It's been around for 160 years. It's got a tradition of excellence. Bionic Ear was developed here. There's, for 160 years, this has been the pinnacle of research in Australia. It's a top 40 university across the world. It is phenomenal in terms of what has been able to be achieved from the university. Are you willing to be a part of that?
Yes, of course.
Well, in that case, welcome to the club.
Wow. Thanks so much.
Thanks so much.
No worries.
We put a lot of time and effort into it, and you know, we didn't come away with a great feeling on Tuesday, and yeah, so this is unexpected. We're over the moon.
Fantastic. Thank you, Owen. This is great. thanks very much.
You should have
Yeah. Congratulations.
Congratulations. You sneaky guys.
Congratulations. Seriously.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
I've got some good news. We've got onto the MAP program. So I'm to keep his eyes on the road.
Yes! Thank you. Oh, I was like, they don't give it to us. I'm gonna like dump the sofa in front of their office or something. I was like, take it. You've taken everything from us.
That's right.
Cool.
That's great.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We won't let you down, guys.
One of my good friends has a very successful father in business, and his motto was, life is the game and money is the score. And my friend disagreed with this. And my friend said that life is the game, but experiences are the score, and I completely agree. When it comes to the end of my lifetime, I'd like to be able to look back and say I had a wonderful range of experiences and was part of something special along the way. And I think being in my position is unique and incredibly rewarding because I get to be involved in a whole bunch of different businesses as they are started. And we don't know yet how they're going to go and what they're going to end up doing, but it's an incredible process to be involved in, and we know that we're onto something special here, and we know that in a few years' time we're going to be able to look back on the work that we've done and say, yes, we contributed to developing some amazing businesses that are going to build brilliant products and have a massive impact on our economy and on the lifestyle of those who use those products.